let's look back to the first generation, 1G. It's the network those early bulky cell phones worked on. 2G added the ability to send text messages, hello emojis, but you still had to type them on a keypad. 3G turned our cell phones into mini internet-connected computers. 4G made them fast enough to stream all the cat videos you could ever want. And now 5G takes it all one giant step further and 100 times faster. A network powerful enough to safely run a hyper-connected world beyond your cell phone, with millions of self-driving cars, delivery drones, smart homes, and even entire cities. But there's a catch. This fast internet travels on tiny wavelengths, much shorter than the ones the current 4G networks work on. That means cell towers or receptors will need to be much closer. Right now, the 4G range is about 70 kilometers. 5G can only travel a very short 300 meters. So future networks will need thousands of mini base stations everywhere, all over a city to relay the signals. Much more complex and much more expensive. And right now, small parts of those networks are already being built. I am in the upper levels of Rogers Centre in Toronto, and if you look up there, you will see one of dozens of new cell antennas installed to support 5G technology. It's what the future of wireless will look like in fully functioning lightning speed networks that will be a reality in some parts of the world in just a couple of years.